Hello children, welcome to the digital classes. Today we are going to deal about the chapter Adaptations in Different Ecosystem, Part 1. Children, you can see the differentiation between the goat which is present over here and the Himalayan goat. You can see the type of skin it has. Right children? The fur. Now children, we can see the slide with different types of clothes. Yes, these are the clothes which we wear in the summer. These are the clothes which we wear in the rainy season, and these are the clothes which we wear in the winter season. Now children, let's see the summer clothes. They are short and cotton type. Rainy season, they are rexine type to protect us from the rain. Now the winter clothes, muffler, scarf and the gloves. So we do change according to the climate in and around us. So let's deal about the adaptations in different ecosystems. An ecosystem is a geographic area where plants, animals and microorganisms live. Ecosystem consists of biotic as well as abiotic factors. Biotic. Children, biotic means which has life. Biotic factors includes plants, animals and microorganisms. Abiotic, which do not have life, that is temperature, pressure and salinity. Now children, these abiotic factors plays an important role in biotic factor. Now children, you can see the ecological niche, the food chain. These are the producers, primary consumers, secondary consumers, tertiary consumers and the carnivores. So in each and every ecosystem, the life depend on the further food chain. So children, you can see the food chain, right? Now habitat. Do you feel that tree is the only habitat for crow and cow? No. Tree is the habitat for small insects, right? Birds, which give shelter to the cattle, right? Now, habitat is a place where an organism makes its home. All the environmental conditions an organism needs to survive, it needs to gather food, select a mate and successfully reproduce. Now, habitat children. Two types of habitats are there. Terrestrial, that is land, aquatic, water. Now, terrestrial habitat. These contains forest, desert, grasslands. Aquatic habitat, ponds, rivers, lakes, oceans. These are the Amazon rainforest and this is the polar region. Now, adaptation. An organism adjusts themselves to diverse and distinct changes in ecosystem. Organisms have to adapt different means for better survival. Children, these are mangrove plants. These mangrove plants live in wet and salty places. It always lives in the water. Now children, we know that with the help of roots, the plant take in water and the xylem transport the water to all parts of the plant. Now, when the plant is always in water, it doesn't respire. So the roots adapt themselves. So the mangrove roots grow like lateral roots above 12 inches from the soil. You can see here children. They are growing about 12 inches from the water. These are the roots. These are called as pneumatophores. Pneumato means children filled with air. So they are air breathing roots. So you can see children, the lateral roots are protruding out. So they grow in wet and salty place. They have evolved to have curious looking sections from their roots called pneumatophores or knees. So these roots helps in breathing. So they exchange the oxygen and give off the carbon dioxide. Now these knees, aerial roots, develop from the lateral roots that are growing near the surface and protrude up to 12 inches out of the soil or sediment. So they aid the plants in maintaining adequate root respiration in watery environment. So the organisms adopt or develop over a certain period of time in different conditions for better survival. So children, let's see the other activity. Take two potted plants, one plant as aloe vera, one plant as blossom plant. Now, please do not water the plant for 1 week. Just water the plant before 1 week for 1 teaspoon or 1 tablespoon. After 1 week, we observe that the aloe vera plant sustained, the other plant dried off. Now, what is the reason? Now, children, the aloe vera plant adapt to desert conditions. Now, the water which we pour before the 1 week, it retained in the stem, right? Now, these are the aquatic plants, Icornia, then Hydrilla and Pistia. So, these are the xerophytic plants. This is cactus and the aloe vera. Now, children, this is Opuntia. Children, you can see thorn-like projections. So, in this Opuntia, the leaves are modified into spines to avoid the transpiration process. What happens in the transpiration process, children? Yes, the water is evaporated. So, to compensate the water loss, they have evolved the spines. So, the leaves are reduced into spines in Opuntia. Now, children, the stem is called as succulent stem because it stores the water. We can clearly see in the aloe vera, children, right? So, they store the water in the stem. That's the reason the stem is called as succulent stem. The leaves are reduced to spines, so the transpiration loss is checked. Then water is stored in the tissues of the stem, that is called as succulent stem. You can see, children, baobab tree here, the trunk is filled with water. It grows in the desert areas, children. So, the baobab tree is, the trunk is filled with water. This is kind of adaptation. So, in baobab tree, the trunk is swollen. It stores water in its trunk and survives the scorching heat of dry seasons. So, children, these are the living stones. This is a plant called as pebble plant. They are looking like pebbles, no, children, right? You can see the pebble plant. This is pebble plant called as living stones. It cheats the organisms which comes to eat it. So, the swollen leaves are adapted to desert conditions, minimizing the water loss and storing water. Each pebble is actually a leaf with a cut window that lets in the light. You can see, children, this is the leaf and this is the cut window which is allowing the light to get in to process the photosynthesis. The stone-like appearance deceives the animals and saves it from being eaten. So, this is the adaptation by the pebble plant, children. So, they are called as what? Yes, they are called as living stones. This is agave, Kittanara. This is a xerophytic plant grown as fence around the crop fields. Children, these are again the xerophytic plants which are ornamental, which we decorate in our home, right, children? Now, we will learn about specific animal called as camel. This is the camel, children, king of the desert, right, children? This has hump and long legs, voluntary nostrils which close when the sand comes, and the these are the eyelashes which close, children. Let's see in detail. You can see the big long eyelashes which protect the camel from the sand wind, and the voluntary nostrils close when the sand wind occurs. So the hump stores fat for later use, long eyelashes protect eye from sand, nostrils voluntary close to protect from blowing sand, long legs keep the body away from the hot ground. This is the adaptation shown by the camel, children. Now, this is the sidewinder snake, sidewinder adder snake. It crawls sideways with only a small amount of its body pressed against the hot sand. So, this technique helps to keep itself cool. This is the golden mole, children. It do not have eyes, so it escapes the heat of the sun by swimming through the sand just below the surface. It rarely emerges out as it finds all the needs below the ground. Now, this is kangaroo rat of western North American desert, can live without drinking water throughout its life because its body synthesizes little water in the process of digestion. Now, this is the sand grouse, children, the desert bird which flies long distance to an oasis for water, which it carries back in its crop for its nestlings. So, crop is the stomach, children, which is called as stomach in birds. So, it stores water for its nestlings. This is fennec fox, children. They have furry soles which help to walk on the hot sand and loses heat through its ears. So, this is the sand diving lizard, children. When the sand becomes too hot, the sand diving lizard holds its feet in the air to cool down. So, these are the adaptations shown by some animals. So, some adaptations are shown by animals called as nocturnals. Nocturnals which come around during night to avoid the day temperature. Right, children? So, the animals which are active during night and sleep during day, they have highly developed senses of hearing and smell. So, they have specially adopted eyesight to see well in dark. So this is the best example for nocturnal children. Bat emits a high pitched sound which bounces off objects to find prey or protect from predators. This is the firefly children. This exhibit bioluminescence, an organisms which produce and emits light. So the sparkles of fireflies on a summer night is produced as a result of a chemical reaction in their glowing abdomens. So this is cuttlefish children, which is again nocturnal. This is the owl, which is again nocturnal. So aquatic ecosystem, there are two different types of aquatic ecosystem children: fresh water and the marine. Now fresh water ecosystems consist of rivers, ponds and lakes. Marine, seas and oceans. So if the seashore is present, this is called as sea children, this is the ocean. So aquatic adaptations, special air sacs present inside the bodies or presence of such substances that helps organisms to swim and float in water to inhabit at different levels in the water body. So children, you can see here the flippers of the tortoise and fins of the fishes. So they bear specialized structures to swim like flippers as in turtles and fins in the fishes. You can see children, fishes like dolphins etc. have floaters in their body. So these are specialized structures in the digestive canal to be able to inhabit at particular levels in the water body. So children, these are the tiny droplets of water. Children, when you pour oil on the water, it will float on the surface of the water. So oil acts as a floating substances. So the microscopic photosynthetic organism like plankton have droplets of oil in their cells that keeps them float. The larger plants have long, tough leaves and flexible stems. Marine ecosystem. So marine ecosystem, they have four different types of abiotic factors, children. That is salinity, the amount of salt content present in the water, temperature, sunlight and the pressure. Salinity, children, we all know that ocean water is salty, right? The presence of salt in the water. So that is salinity, the temperature, sunlight and pressure. Temperature, children, temperature decreases deep down in the water, depends on the sunlight penetration. So the temperature decreases as we go deep down. So oceans have great depths, so penetration isn't possible. Salinity, the salt content in water is high in sea and oceans, low salt content in ponds, lakes and rivers. As the salinity increases, pressure also increases. Children, you can see here, temperature decreases, salinity increases and the pressure also increases. So temperature is very prominent. Temperature depends on the penetration of sunlight. Sunlight, temperatures vary dramatically between the surface and the ocean floor. So on the surface of the ocean, the penetration of sunlight is very well, children. You can see here, when we go deep down, it will be very dark. You can see clearly here, children, the penetration of sunlight, right? So when the penetration of sunlight is present, the temperature is optimum. When there is no sunlight, the temperature decreases and the pressure increases, salinity also increases. So air breathing surface dwellers like us and the fishes have specialized structures in their body. Let's see them, children. These are the seals. So seals, what they do is they are very weight, they have the body very weight, children. So what they do to swim down, they collapse their lungs. When they collapse their lungs, it becomes heavy and they sink down without using their flippers, right, children? So they do not swim down. So when they have to come up, they have specialized structures in their blood which are very specific oxygen binds. So with the help of them, they again come up. So the seals, they collapse their lungs to sink. When they collapse their lungs, they become very weight, so they sink down. So once a seal lungs have collapsed, its lungs, it becomes heavier than water and so it sinks. Thus it does not have flap like flippers all the way down. It reaches great depths mostly by gliding effortlessly, saving its oxygen stores for the strenuous climb back to the surface. So these are the sperm whale's children. So instead of fighting the pressure, they let it collapse their lungs completely. Some oxygen remains in the lungs. Children, we know that oxygen helping the aerobic respiration. Right, children? They give out energy. So instead of fighting against the pressure, they will collapse their lungs. So when they collapse their lungs, their body becomes very heavy. When it becomes heavy, they slowly sink down, right? So they are storing some amount of oxygen in the lungs. So they slowly come up by using that oxygen in the form of respiration. So some oxygen remains in their lungs, but they mostly store it in their muscles where it is needed. Their muscle tissue contains much higher concentration of oxygen binding chemicals than our muscles. You can see, children, lung like swim bladder. Specifically, swim bladder again help them to float. Let's see. So they move up in the water column by releasing gas into the bladder and inflating it, and down by reabsorbing the gas into the blood. Children, when they want to move up, they will inflate the bladder. Inflate means, children, when you blow a balloon, the balloon inflates. So when they inflate their swim bladder, they will come up. When they need to go down, they will again reabsorb the gas and they will sink down. This is the adaptations, right? So a swim bladder does not collapse at depth because the gas inside is at the same pressure as the water outside. If the external pressure suddenly decreases, the bladder will swell greatly. When such a fish is brought up from depth, it swims bladder stick out of its mouth. So this is other type of fish, children, which has swim bladder. So these are the swim bladders, children, which are economically very expensive and they are edible also. Right, children, now the fishes have the gills, which again aid in their respiration. So they have gills also. Specialized developed kidneys, gills and the body functions help to maintain salt concentration across membranes through osmosis. Children, we will know in this chapter in the other session about this salinity adaptation. So children, these are the anemones or worms take up the gases through the skin. So the mobile animals, mobile means, children, which are moving, right? Mobile animals use gills such as fishes or even lungs. We could see, children, lungs to take up oxygen from the water and the air. All the animals in the ocean release carbon dioxide into the water as a waste, which is then used by the plants to produce energy. How, children? Yes, by the process of photosynthesis. Let's see. Now, what do a plant do with carbon dioxide? We know, children, the carbon dioxide and the water in the presence of sunlight and the chlorophyll, the plant produces the glucose, water and the oxygen. Now, children, the oxygen which is produced in the process of photosynthesis is again used by the animals. Now, animals release the waste product, that is carbon dioxide. So one waste is a benefit for other, right, children? So as we know, children, the temperature decreases as we go deep down to the ocean floor. Why, children? Because of the sunlight penetration. Many marine mammals have blubber for insulation. To keep up the body heat, they have blubber for insulation. So the blubber is also edible, children, is eaten by most parts of the world. Now, the Antarctic toothfish have antifreeze like substances in their blood to keep it flowing. The antifreeze proteins, along with the normal body salt, depress the freezing point of blood and body fluids to 2.5 degrees centigrade, slightly below the freezing point at the of sea water. So these proteins bind to and inhibit growth of ice crystals within body fluids through an absorption inhibition process. So the proteins bind to ice crystals, keeping them small to prevent the formation of fish popsicles. So children, you can see here, animals and plants live on the surfaces water. Why? Because the access of sunlight is very much present. When sunlight is present, the photosynthesis occur. The food is being there more. So the high nutrient levels increase temperature, reduce pressure and more sunlight. In deep seas, children, they must live in high pressure, cold, dark waters with scarce nutrients. So children, barnacles and mussels have developed mechanism that allow them to cling to rocks to avoid washed away by the strong waves. Children, the symbiosis between sea anemone and the clownfish. This is the sea anemone, children. They have tentacles and this is the clownfish. So they undergo the symbiosis process, means helping each other. How do they help? Let's see. Now, how clownfish get benefited? Sea anemones live attached to the surface of coral reefs. So this allows the clownfish to swim comfortably between the tentacles of anemones, in which the potential predators are killed off by anemone stings. Now, how sea anemone get benefited? The clownfish chases away the butterfly fish that would eat the anemone. This is the symbiosis between anemones and clownfish. Sea anemones can do very little to control the flow of water across their bodies, and they rely on local currents to bring in oxygen and nutrients. Camouflage. Children, camouflage, we can see, camouflage is the use of any combination of materials, coloration or illumination for concealment, either by making animals or object hard to see or by disguising them as something else. Children, the cuttlefish and the chameleon are the best example for camouflage. Children, they will change its body color according to the surroundings. This is the owl. You can see, children, we cannot predict the owl, children, right? So these are the adaptations and the camouflage. Defensive behavior by an animal to avoid being harmed by another involves defensive aggressions against a potential predator or against a member of its own species. Outside the group or animal escape behavior to avoid the source of harm. Children, you can see, this is the octopus. It will release bluish ink-like fluid and it will escape. This is the defensive behavior, children. Snakes, when being threatened, they will hiss. This is the hedgehog. Children, when it is being defended, it will open up its spines. Reproductive strategies are structural, functional and behavior adaptations that improve the chances of fertilization or increase the survival rate. Asexual reproduction requires only one parent. Offsprings have 100% the same chromosomes as the parent. You can see, children, Hydra is producing by the asexual reproduction by budding. Children, the frog will release more number of eggs to survive. Whales and herringbills have adapted the ability to travel long distances and the ability to survive in a variety of environments. The marine ecosystem, on the basis of availability of light at different depths, are demarcated. Temperature varies dramatically between the surface and the ocean floor. Children, as I told you, sunlight plays a very prominent role in the process of animals and the plants to live in. Right, children? The sunlight will give out the temperature, which is very much present on the surface, and it gets slow, might mean slow, when we go deep down to the ocean floor. Different zones in the marine ecosystem. Euphotic zone. First zone is euphotic zone. Second zone, bathyal zone. Third zone, that is abyssal zone. Euphotic. Photic means, children, light. So the first zone is called as euphotic zone, means the sunlight zone. Bathyal zone, the twilight zone. Children, on the new moon day, the light of the moon shows the twilight. Right, children? So the bathyal zone is called as twilight zone. Third zone, that abyssal zone, that is dark and cold zone. Children, these are the three types of zones. So this is oceanic zone, light, temperature, depth, plants and animals. So children, the first zone, euphotic zone, sunlight zone. It is brightly light. So the temperature is 30 degrees. Depth 0 to 200 meters. The plants and animals which will live in the euphotic zone are planktons, physalia, dolphins, flying fish, green turtles and the sea anemones. Now, second zone, children, that is bathyal zone, twilight zone. It is dimly, as I told you, children, the moonlight, that is full moon day, 4 to 3 degrees centigrade. The depth is 200 meters to 2000 meters. The plants and animals are whales, plant and fish, red brown kelps, sea cucumbers, fish, squids, octopus, sponges, corals, etc. Abyssal zone, that is dark zone, which is dark 2 to 3 degrees centigrade. The depth is 200 meters to 6000 meters. The animals are brittle star, angler fish, tripod fish. Children, the euphotic zone, bathyal zone, the abyssal zone. Three zones are divided by the light penetration, temperature, depth and the pressure. Children, on the surface of the ocean is called as euphotic zone. As I told you, penetration of sunlight is very much present. So, 80% of flora and fauna are found in euphotic zone. Bathyal zone, penetration of light is very much low. That's the reason it is called as twilight zone. Abyssal zone, completely the light is absent. Here, the organisms have to live in very cold temperature. Pressure is high, right children? Pressure is high, temperature is low, salinity is very high. So, these are the three types of oceanic zones. So, how many zones can you see in the figure on the basis of light penetration, children? Name them. Yes, those are euphotic zone and the bathyal zone. What types of abiotic conditions do you find as per the given table? That is temperature, pressure and the sunlight. We can see the depth also, children, right? Now, what will affect adaptations to marine life other than the conditions shown in the table and figure? That is pressure and the salinity. What happens to the temperature and pressure as the depth increases? Temperature decreases and the pressure increases. Which zone has more animals? 80% of flora, fauna are in the euphotic zone because of the good amount of light penetration, photosynthetic activity and availability of food. So, children, what we have learnt? An ecosystem is a geographic area where plants, animals and microorganisms live. Ecosystem consists of biotic, that is which have life, that is plants and animals. Abiotic factors, that means which do not have life, that is temperature, pressure and the sunlight. But children, the abiotic factors may vary according to the biotic factors and highly influence the biotic life. That's the reason they go for adaptations, right? Biotic factors includes plants, animals and microorganisms. Habitat is a place where an organism makes its home. All the environmental condition an organism needs to survive, it needs to gather food, select a mate and successfully reproduce. Organisms adjust themselves to diverse and distinct changes in ecosystems. Organisms have to adapt different means for better survival. Mangroves grow in a wet and salty place. They have evolved to have curious looking projections from their roots called pneumatophores or knees. The leaves of Opuntia are reduced to spines, so the transpiration loss is checked. Water is stored in the tissues of the stem called as succulent stem, that is we have seen in aloe vera plant. Right, children? Now, in baobab tree, the trunk is swollen. It stores water in its trunk and survives the scorching heat of drying seasons. Now, the pebble plant called as living stones, right? So, it deceives the animals from being eaten. Right, children? So, it has stone-like appearance and have cut window, right, for the photosynthesis. Special air sacs inside the bodies or presence of such substances that helps organisms to swim and float in water to inhabit different levels in the water body. Oceans and sea lungs have collapsed. It becomes heavier than water. So, it sinks all the way down to reach great depths mostly by gliding effortlessly. Many marine animals have blubber for insulation from cold and some fishes have antifreeze-like substances in their blood. Brightly colored clownfish have adapted symbiotic relationship with anemones to protect both clownfish and the anemone from predators. Marine adaptations also include symbiosis, camouflage, defensive behavior, reproductive strategy, contact and communication like most other ecosystems on Earth. Embryo learning, children. What do you understand by adaptations in organisms and why do they adapt? Second, with the help of two examples, explain how these organisms have adapted themselves in ecosystem. What special adaptations can be seen in the following organisms? Mangrove trees, camel, fish, dolphins, planktons. Write the effect of temperature on the organism adapted in the lake and pond in the tabular form. For better understanding of the concept, solve the worksheet. Please visit the official website of the SCRT. Children, till now we have seen the adaptations of different ecosystems by the animals. In the next session, we will be dealing about specifically marine ecosystem and freshwater ecosystem. Thank you.